Welcome, I'm John Terrell, Aviation Maintenance Instructor. In this video, you'll learn about digital logic gates. For most aviation maintenance technicians, or AMTs, the complexities of electrical circuits in modern aircraft present a challenge both in terms of understanding how the circuit performs its design task and troubleshooting when it fails to do so. To make both of these tasks easier, digital logic symbols and diagrams are used to describe not how a circuit is wired or works, but rather how a circuit functions. How a circuit works and how a circuit functions may seem very close to the same thing, but to illustrate the difference, consider the French fry press you might find at a local sandwich shop. You can see that there is a handle that, when pulled, lowers a press, which pushes a potato through the cutter, slicing it into French fries. This is how the press works. Now look at the press with the center section obscured. You can see a handle. You know that you must insert a potato and pull the handle to make French fries come out the bottom of the press. This is how the press functions. You know what goes in, what action must be taken, and what the result is, but you don't have to know how the press accomplishes the task. With such a simple machine, this seems like an unnecessary distinction, but in very complex electrical circuits, this method makes understanding the circuit much easier. Logic diagrams do the same thing. There are several logic diagram symbols that represent different gate functions. The most common logic symbols are the AND, OR, exclusive OR, and NOT. The AND gate represents two things that must be true to make another thing true. Only if A is true and B is true will Y be true. Another way to envision the gate is with a simple circuit consisting of two switches and a lamp in series. To make the lamp illuminate, we must close both switch A and switch B. The OR gate represents two things, either one of which must be true to make another thing true. If A is true and B is false, then Y is true. If B is true and A is false, then Y is true. Note that if A is true and B is true, then Y is true. Technically, the OR function is also an AND function. To make the lamp illuminate, we must close switch A or switch B, or we can close both switch A and switch B. The exclusive OR gate represents two things, either one of which must be true to make another thing true. If A is true and B is false, then Y is true. If B is true and A is false, then Y is true. Note that this time, if A is true and B is true, then Y will be false. This is the only difference between the OR function and the exclusive OR function. Let's get back to our lamp. To make it illuminate, we may close switch A or switch B. But closing both switch A and switch B will result in the lamp not being illuminated. The NOT has a very simple job, which is to change the output condition to the opposite of the input condition. In other words, if input A is true, then output Y will be false. If input A is false, then output Y will be true. Now let's look at a real-world example of this simplification. Consider an aircraft landing gear warning circuit. It is designed to perform two tasks. If all three landing gear are down and safely locked, the circuit will display a green light. If all of the landing gear are not down and locked, and the throttle is pulled back to idle, the landing gear warning circuit will display a red light and sound a horn, warning the pilot that if he has reduced power to land the aircraft, the landing gear is not currently safe to support the plane on the ground. This is a schematic of the electrical wiring of the landing gear warning circuit. It tells you what components are electrically connected to what other components, but it does not make clear what the circuit actually does. We see that all three landing gear are down and locked, the green light comes on. Understanding how a complex electrical circuit works by looking at an electrical circuit schematic or at the circuit itself can be very difficult. Investigating the cause of a misbehaving electrical circuit can be made much easier by using logic symbols and functions to understand both how the circuit should function and the ways in which it is not functioning as designed. Thanks for joining me to learn about digital logic gates. Look for our other videos on aircraft maintenance.